Hi, this is Tense here. Today we are going to be reviewing a 3D printer we just received. In this video, we are printing a new spool holder. We've had some 3D printers here, but with the reduction in prices and increasing quality, we wanted to acquire a larger printer. After some searching, we decided to go with a Delta style printer, and we ordered a He3D-K200 model that was just released. We ordered it through 3D Printers Bay for $199 shipped, and there will be a link in the description. This printer has a printing diameter of 200mm and is 300mm tall. After ordering, it took about a week to ship, and they shipped via DHL, which took around 3 days to arrive. On the day we received the printer, we decided to put it together. In total, it took around 4 to 5 hours to assemble, using the video guide that is available on YouTube. The overall quality of the kit is quite good, and the assembly was straightforward. Even though it is advertised as auto-leveling, we knew that before we ordered it that it did not have a full-time auto-leveling feature, but instead included a temporary level calibration sensor to help you set up the leveling. We will probably upgrade to a full-time auto-leveling down the road. During the whole process, we did encounter some issues. The first was that the three top timing pulley screws were too short and had to be replaced with longer 3mm threaded screws. We also added a spacer for the top timing pulley. Otherwise, the assembly was straightforward and went together well. After assembly, we powered it up and connected it to a repeater host program for calibration. When we connected up the Z-axis pressure calibration sensor, we could not get it to work. We ended up modifying an extra limit switch that was included in the kit. Initially, we used zip ties, but we printed a holder. We wanted to mount it permanently in case we wanted to recalibrate without doing more work. During the calibration process, we found out that the glass build plate was moving when mounted using the 6 screws that were recommended. This meant that we could not get a consistent calibration reading. To fix this, we printed a clamp that held down the build plate. The link is down below in the description. During the calibration process, the lack of good documentation meant that we needed to do a lot of research. We may do a calibration video down the road to help others having this problem. After calibration, we went to do our first print. Because we wanted to run this printer as a standalone, we put a sample code onto the SD card that was included with the kit and plugged it in. The printer would recognize the SD card, but would not see any of the files that were on it. After trying several different cards, we found only a couple that would work. This may be an issue with the reader, and is something that we will keep an eye on. During the first print, the lack of setup information meant that we needed to do some trial and error. For example, the cold end fan would not turn on during the print. It would be nice to have a sample G-code file that could be used for the initial setup and test. In conclusion, we are really happy with the quality, but we would not recommend it to a first-time 3D printer owner. With some work, we were able to obtain good quality prints, and $199 for a 3D printer this size is a good deal. We hope that this review will help you in choosing if you are considering this printer. As usual, all the links will be in the description, and subscribe if you are interested in these type of videos. We'll be doing one on calibration as well as a review on the Monoprice Mini 3D printer. Thank you for watching!